Paul Hitchcock, retired as a lieutenant colonel. And he says, Hitch, he says, you're coming to Cherry Point. What do you want to do? And I said, well, I'll take an F-4 squadron. He says, you're too old for that. He says, how about coming in as executive of C-252 transports? And I said, okay, but I've never flown transport, so, but he said, no sweat. That's what happened. I think about things that have happened over the years in flying in combat and flying in C-130s and so forth, little incidents that have happened. And like one of them in particular, we were carrying a load of students who were at school at El Toro on the West Coast back to Cherry Point. But there were some of them from the Air Force students who were taking the same course. So we stopped at this base down in Alabama or Mississippi, I'm not sure which one it was now, to drop some of these students off. And we were getting ready to take off. It was at night, and getting ready to take off for Cherry Point. And the outboard engine starter was busted, wouldn't work. So I said, we talked to the flight engineer, and I says, if we make a high-speed run down the runway and get that prop turning fast enough, we can hit the igniter and start it. And he says, you can do. So we got permission, offloaded all the passengers, requested from the tower to make a high-speed run down the active runway, and which we did. Got the prop wound up, got it started, came back, loaded them up, came back to Cherry Point. You people are the pilots of these current C-130. Get to know it well and always keep up with what's going on in that airplane, because it changes and there's always something that might come up that you should have a background in to react to any emergency, stuff like that. And take good care of the crew, because they're the lifeblood of that organization.